Television presents Tony Hancock in...
Hancock's Half Hour.
Oh, dear. Oh, this is hopeless. Let's face it, you don't like me, do you?
No, I don't.
Charming. Thank you very much. Took you long enough to find out, didn't it? You had a dance, a fish supper, and a ride home. What more do you want?
Well, oh, that's nice, isn't it? Casting that up in me face. It wasn't much, was it? I've had better nights.
You've seen better days, too, dear.
Then, isn't it? I'm not going to stay here and be insulted. I'm going home.
No, don't go. I'm sorry. I didn't mean that. We mustn't allow a very charming evening to degenerate into a sordid punch-up. Now, come on.
Let me go. I'm under no obligation to you. You're all the same. A cheap dance and a fish supper, and you think you own a girl.
Well, stone me, woman, if you felt like that, why did you bother to go out with me in the first place?
I wouldn't have done if I'd known I was going to be lumbered with you.
Lumbered?
I said to my friend when I met you, I bet I get stuck with the fat one.
How dare you, you peroxided Jezebel. You were quite happy to stand by all night watching me lashing all my money out.
Phew, 4 and 6.
You had a gin and bitter lemon in the dance hall.
And it had to last me all night.
Quite right too, I hate drunken women.
Well, I don't think we've anything more to say to each other.
You see, she's grateful. Now come along now, Madam Pete.
No, I'm going home.
How you doing?
Horrible.
Keep her there. I'm doing all right here. If yours goes, mine'll go.
She doesn't like me. Well, keep her amused. Keep her amused? What do you suggest? A few card tricks? Waggle me ears? Do a funny dance? You're all right. Yours is grateful. Come on, let's change over for a bit.
All right, I don't mind. Hello, then.
Oh, hello.
What's all this about going home? You don't want to go home, do you?
Not now.
No, I'm good, you don't.
Muriel, are you ready? Are you coming home?
Oh, for crying out loud, are they trying to be friendly?
Oh, stop it. Go away.
I've only just got here.
I
want
to go home.
You're quite happy to stop here just now.
Well, that was different. Your friend was here.
Oh, let's face it, you don't like me either, do you?
No, not much.
Oh, this is ridiculous. You've got no taste, some of you girls. You're not used to going out with class. That's your trouble. You don't recognise it when you see it. Go on, hop it. Go on, clear up. Clear off. Go on. Come on, break it up. We're going home.
What do you mean, going home?
Come on, we're going home. I've had enough of this. Had enough humiliation heaped on me for one night.
Oh, what's the matter with him?
You better go home, dear, before I forget I'm a gentleman. Now go on, push off.
All right, I'm going. Come on, Edie. Don't let's waste any more time on this middle-aged Ted. Let's go down to the youth club.
The youth club? You two? Go on, get your leopard-skin legs out of here.
You want to get rid of him, mate. He's a right drag on you.
I shall be forced to fill you in a minute, madam.
That's it. Go on, hit her, lady. Go on, hit her.
All right, show me your lady and I will hit her. That way no, mate. That way no. Nobody to reply to that.
Never mind about him. Well, I'll see you tomorrow night, then.
Well, only if you're by yourself.
Get him and we'll all go out together.
Okay. Ta-da.
Tomorrow night, then, outside the factory. He'll carry your welding equipment home for you.
Why do you have to store around?
I had it all sewn up there, money in the bank. Sydney, I'm not going to stand here being insulted by rubbish like that. I have my pride, you know.
That's just about all you have got. Same thing happens every Saturday night. You're all having to spoil it for me. We find a couple of charmers, I go like a bomb and you get up their nose. What do you say to them?
My courting habits are no concern of yours.
They are when it ruins my night out. I'm telling you, mate, I'm thinking dead seriously of going out of my totting future.
Oh, well, please yourself. I'm thinking of turning it in anyway. I think I'll go into a monastery. I think my hair started going as it is.
Oh, now you're talking a lot of rubbish.
Well, what's the point of going on? I never do any good. It's an eternal quest for feminine company. I'm miles behind me reading. I don't know what's going on in Ghana. Winds of change are howling away out there and I don't know the first thing about it.
Yeah, you might as well go into a monastery. You're no good out here. You might as well spend the rest of your life making tonic wine as wander about the streets frightening the life out of all the birds.
You make me sound like Bela Lugosi, the werewolf of East Cheam.
Wandering the streets, it's all right for you, you don't have to bother. They all flock round you. I don't understand it with a face like yours. It's all these Ernest Borgnines and Jack Palances that are doing it. It's the day of the ugly man, there's no doubt about it. Look at you. You're almost prehensile. It's beyond me. I suppose you must have some primitive, prehistoric, animal-like fascination for them. Of course, my trouble is I'm too civilized. I realize that. Much too sophisticated. I'm too dilettante for them. No doubt about it, you can be too intelligent.
Oh, don't give me that. You don't do any good with the posh birds either. You have tried every type of bird round here, from the young conservative to the biscuit factory. And none of them fancy you. Me? Completely different. I can't help it, I'm just attractive to women. What the boat race looks like doesn't mean a thing. They take one look at me and they go, that boy's been around. Strength, confidence, that's what they want. Somebody who's going to dominate them.
Dear, oh dear, 1960 and they haven't advanced since the club on the head and drag them off by the hair days. Very distressing for we poets. Is there no room for the aesthete anymore? The delicate courtship. The locket of hair for her to wear around her neck. The shy, stolen glances across the aisle of the church of a Sunday morning. The heart delicately carved in the old oak tree. The pressed rose in the book of Browning.
Yeah, I don't go for any of that rubbish, mate. A quick go over the choppers with a brush full of striped toothpaste and straight at it.
Charming, very romantic, very Daphne du Maurier, that is. No flowers, no chocolate.
No, none of that. If it's a bit of class, I might give my shoes a rub over, but that's me lot.
I don't understand it, Sydney. We live in two different worlds.
Yeah, well, there's nobody in yours worth talking about, is it?
There's no need to be so cruel. When you're 35 and birdless, the world can be a very lonely place.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't know about that. I've got more than I can handle. I've got to get rid of two tomorrow night. You can have a crack at them if you like.
Have a crack at them? Sometimes your phraseology revolts me. I don't know why, buddy, but I don't know why Shakespeare bothered with blokes around like you.
Well, you don't know what you're doing. You've got no idea. All this corny old stuff about a horned gramophone in a punt up at Maidenhead. This is all dead. It went out years ago.
Well, my way is not your way. I'm far too couth. Giving the shoes a shine up the back of the trouser leg is not me, and it never has been. I like to do things properly. Everybody's not like you, you know. Don't worry. I'll find a way. I'll think of something.
Don't know what you're waiting for. The last bus went hours ago.
Oh. Another late night. 5 miles to walk home and with feet like mine.
No, never mind. Billy Buckley might be waiting there for us with a check.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Can I help you? Yes, I see I can. There we are, sir. That's much better. We must pay attention to details.
Don't you start. Now then, I've come about this advertisement in last night's paper. Men, are you lonely? Are you unattractive to women?
Yes.
Well, I am. It says here the Mayfair Charm School for Men guarantees I'll be knocking around with starlets and models within a fortnight.
Oh, yes, sir. Our course guarantees to transform lifelong wallflowers into rare and beautiful orchids.
Yes. Yes, I suppose that's one way of putting it. You can be sure that I shall be much sought after by the opposite, if you'll pardon the expression, gender.
Oh! But of course, sir, nothing is impossible for a Mayfair Charm School graduate. You wish to enroll?
By all means, I'd like to start today, if that's possible.
Certainly. We'll just fill out this enrollment form to see which course you are in need of.
Oh, you have more than one course?
Oh, yes, sir. They're graduated. Depending on the type of pupil, we arrange from the Eliza Doolittle transformation course for the complete failures up to the refresher course, which is mainly designed for the returning rubber planter from Malaya type who's got a bit rusty. But don't you worry, sir. We'll soon place you in the right category. Now, if you'll be so kind as to answer these few questions. Name?
Anthony Hancock.
Anthony, age?
30-ish.
Could you be a little more precise?
Early 30s, you know. Not quite over the hump.
Have you ever been married?
No.
Engaged?
No.
Regular girlfriends?
No.
Casual girlfriends?
No.
Do you like women?
Yes. Oh.
Do they like you?
No.
Are you at ease with women?
No.
Are they at ease with you?
No.
Are they antagonistic towards you from the start?
Yes.
Now then, can you dance?
No.
Play a musical instrument?
No.
Can you interest women conversationally?
No.
Can you amuse them?
No.
Do they laugh at you?
Yes.
In which way?
In the worst possible way.
Have you any assets that could be developed to their advantage?
No.
Are you sought out at parties?
No. Sorted out sometimes and then slung out. Well, I reckon it's the Eliza Doolittle, don't you?
There doesn't seem to be much we can seize on, does there?
No, you're going to have to work for your money, eh?
I'm afraid so.
All right, then.
Right, well, that will be 100 guineas, please.
Oh, dear. Well, I'll post you my cheque for tomorrow morning.
That'll be quite all right, Mr. Hancock.
Some girl's going to pay for this one day.
You want me, Mr. Hathaway?
Yes. Will you kindly show Mr. Hancock into the beginner's class, please?
Certainly. Will you come this way, please?
Hello, my dear. What are you doing tonight? I'd like to come down to my place.
If she does that next week, I shall demand my money back.
Here you are. The classes are just about to begin.
Oh, blimey, dear. Take it, anybody here? Good morning, boys.
Good morning.
Good morning. Well, now, let's see you. Now, I'm your instructor, Gregory Chandler. We always call each other by our Christian names. I hope you'll always think of me as Gregory. Today we start our course of social attributes, essential if you are to become attractive male animals.
Yeah, who's he calling an animal?
It's nothing personal, it's just a twist of expression.
Oh, twist his expression, he starts at you.
A man who cannot dance is at a complete disadvantage in his quest for a lady's hand. The rival who has mastered the terpsichorean art will be victorious every time. Statistics prove that 8 out of every 10 married couples met their partners on the dance floor. By the time you leave here, each one of you will be an accomplished dancer, ready to waltz your way into the heart of your chosen one. Clarence and Anthony out here, please. Hurry, we haven't got all day. First of all, the basic steps of the waltz. Follow me, please.
Watch me carefully.
What's he going to do? Knees up by the brown?
Do you mind? This is very serious. Dancing is an extremely important factor in the successful ladies' man, so pay attention, please. The waltz. Left foot forward, right foot forward, but to the right, join left foot to right foot. I shall now do that again. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now then, the two new boys, follow me at once, will you please? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now back. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now then, your turn, Clarence. Do this over several times, will you? Your turn will come later, Anthony. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2.